jiu-jitsu and a brown belt in judo. He is a three-time world Brazilian jiu-jitsu champion at the black belt level and a two-time world champion in Abu Dhabi. Now training under the professor, Javier Cordero, his Muay Thai is some of the most dangerous in the UFC heavyweight division.
As he makes his way towards the cage, his preparation has been perfect. He is in fantastic shape, had an amazing camp, and he believes that he is in the perfect position to become the new champion of the world. As he steps into the octagon right now, he steps in with a champion's mindset.
Once again, making his way to the octagon, looking to defend his title, looking to remain a UFC champion. He's got a big challenge, but he believes he will be able to defend.
The champion is in focus. He is in his prime. He's making his way towards the cage. His training for this camp has been absolutely spectacular. He believes he has a solid game plan, and his mentality coming into this fight is clear and focused.
For our main event of the evening, the Brazilian is 38, the Russian is 40. The Duke will have a 3-inch reach advantage. And with the official introductions, here's the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event.
Great fight.
Here we go, first round, you ready? You ready?
Here we go! Title fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Verdum, black trunks for the champion.
Fabricio Verdum is one of the best submission artists to ever fight in the UFC's heavyweight division. This decorated multiple-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion has radically improved his striking over the years to catch up with his already elite ground game.
Nicely done with the right, yep. He's got the clinch.
Rocks up the palm. Transitions to the Muay Thai clinch.
Now he's in full guard.
He's
nice. Back to full guard.
Manny from the top.
He's an outlaw. not the full mount, Joe.
Here they come again.
Excellent posture here.
They come again.
Both of his eyes are looking pretty swollen now.
Here they come again. Here they come again.
Trying to get them out. He's back up again. Hard leg kick from Fabricio Verdun. Takedown here. And there's a nice straight by Verdun.
Great exchange.
Verdun with the combination.
Wow!
Big straight punch. Back and forth battle. Hard left hand. Great head kick.
He is going after it here.
He can do damage from this Muay Thai front clinch.
He scores with the knee.
All you can hear is support. He blocks that shot to the body. That's a nice hook from the clinch. Great trip, and he completes the takedown.
Try to take it back, I think.
Both hooks in. Attacking the arm here. He's got the leg across the face. He's going to extend his hips. He's got him flattened out on his back. He wants to free that arm. More and more pressure on that arm. He might have to tap. That was a deep arm bar, but a beautiful escape.
Side control.
Nicely done.
Really good movement on the ground.
Now he's in guard.
He postures up and punishes the body.
Wow, quick movement on the ground.
And he got back to guard. Oh, he's got a triangle here. Grabs his ankle, pulls down on his shin. He adjusted the arm bar, throws him over on his back. This arm bar is very deep. Incredible!
It is all
just absolutely incredible! Round's about to end, sunk in that submission and got the victory.
Once again, here's our fight replay.
And we see here, as soon as this arm bar gets locked in, there is no escape. Perfect technique. Tremendous pressure. And here we see it again from another angle. Isolates the arm, locks it in, and forces the tap. And one more time, nice technique here on this submission.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki is going to stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 42 seconds in the very first round. Declared the winner by tap out due to an arm bar. And still, the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, the
And he remains your UFC heavyweight champion.